Valerie. I'm a pet care advisor, and I'm here today with my friend Little Bunny, and we're here to talk to you about hairballs in rabbits. Rabbits, like cats, can get hairballs from ingesting too much fur while they're grooming, or fur that's around their cage or possibly in their food or water dish. So the hairballs can actually mix with food and form an obstruction, and rabbits, unlike cats, can't vomit that obstruction back up. So it can actually cause a very severe problem if not monitored. Some of the symptoms that you might notice if your rabbit had a hairball is they would be, number one, not consuming food. You would also notice possibly a decrease in the amount of feces they produce, and you might also see a lot of fur mixed in with the feces. So you want to definitely be watching that sort of stuff daily, making sure that your rabbit is eating and going to the bathroom properly. If the rabbit is just eating a little bit less and you might suspect that possibly he did have a hairball if it was shedding season and there was a lot of fur coming off the rabbit, you can actually try using some hairball remedy gels. They have them for ferrets and for cats, and you could actually administer this orally for a couple of days. But again, making sure that the rabbit is consuming food and drinking water and able to pass some feces. If not, you want to contact the veterinarian immediately, because if the rabbit is not consuming food for 24 hours, it can, you know, be a very, very severe problem, even death. So some of the ways to prevent hairballs, the number one concern would be to have a high fiber diet. There are high fiber pellets and also grasses and hays such as Timothy hay and oat hay. The oat hay and Timothy hay plus fresh leafy vegetables should be the majority of the rabbit's diet. The pellets should be a smaller portion of the diet, because too many pellets actually have a low moisture content. They may not provide enough moisture to keep the intestinal tract moving properly. But the fiber in these foods can help pass the hair and food through more readily. Hydration is also important. You want to make sure that your rabbit is drinking plenty of fresh, clean water. If you have just a bowl in the cage and the rabbit is shedding, there's going to get a film of fur on top of the water. So keeping it in a water bottle is going to prevent that hair from getting into the water. Actually, exercise is another important aspect of a rabbit's life that can help to keep the gut moving properly. You want to take your rabbit out of the cage daily for exercise runs, either in a supervised area or in a play yard area. This way you can actually see their behavior when they're out loose. If they're not running around, that's definitely a red flag that the rabbit may not be feeling well. So keeping the animal exercise is definitely going to help to you, for you can monitor their behavior, and you can also help their digestive tract move better if they're not just sitting in a cage, you know, not moving around. Grooming is another essential important thing that you need to do for a rabbit. As you can see, rabbit's fur comes out very readily, so you want to be removing this on a daily basis if possible. You can use slicker brushes. A small slicker brush for small dogs or cats is fine to remove this fine hair. You could also use a grooming glove. If your rabbit is not used to getting brushed, a grooming glove might be something that he accepts, just like petting. So that's a helpful thing. Also, you could use a rubber brush such as this Zoom Groom for cats. This has flexible rubber tips that really grab onto the fur and pull a lot of loose fur out. Stress is another factor that causes rabbits to shed more. Little Bunny is not used to being on camera, and you can see he's shedding quite a bit here today. So just the stress of being here with us to film the video is causing him to shed a lot. If you have the rabbit cage in your home in an area that's got too much activity or too many loud noises, that can cause them to be in a constant state of stress, so their shedding would be increased. Also, if you have animals such as dogs, cats, snakes, anywhere around the rabbit's cage, that can stress the rabbit out. Those are predators in his mind, so that would keep him stressed and shedding. So try to reduce the stress for the rabbit as much as possible to reduce the shedding. Finally, there are dietary supplements like papaya tablets. Papaya has enzymes that can help to break up and digest the fur that is ingested a little bit more easily so that they can pass through. So these are just some of the tips to prevent and how to tell if your rabbit does have a hairball, and hopefully you don't ever have that problem. I hope you found this helpful. Thank you.